Welcome to Baking Games the Hard Way. Today we're going to take a look at libGDX, one of the most promising ways to make games for the web, phones, and tablets. Googling libGDX. Here's their website, and hey, some tutorials. Let's try this one. Blah, 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 blah. We're supposed to do something with the libraries tab. Okay, that step was completely pointless. Moving on. Link source, link source, links. Ah, it was right next to the libraries tab. We'll just copy these instructions exactly, and error. Great. Ah, we were in the wrong, nearly identical folder. Now it should work. Error. Good news, we have successfully completed no steps. Okay, here's some actual code. Let's type it out and get a feel for how this stuff works. Still typing. No idea what these Fs here are. Blah, 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 blah. Ah, we have successfully programmed the color green. The real test is to see if we can get this running on a tablet. It's green. Hold on, I have an idea. Wah. On to tutorial number two. Wah, what? How do you get this program to see that there's a picture here? Of course, you just click on this obscure little refresh button. We have successfully made a game that displays a single picture forever. If you liked this video, please subscribe and stay tuned for the next episode of Baking Games the Hard Way. See you then. We'll be right back.